So I'm at the Halifax Public Gardens, and last year you saw my video that I did showing the bees dying that were landing in the flowers. This year I'm back, it's now just the beginning of October, and there's been almost no bees all summer long. And I found these two flowers here, and there's a few other ones around here, but I'm going to zoom into these two flowers to show you that the situation with the bees, when they come to eat on the flowers, they die. We'll take a look at these two flowers. What do you see here? You see dead bees. And I'm going to back up a bit more so the camera can focus better because I'm too close. So I'm in a garden here, which is the Dahlia garden at the public gardens, and there's no bees around here. You can look all around, there's all these beautiful flowers everywhere. There should be a whole pile of bees and there is none. But I found these flowers and there's a few other ones I saw and they have dead bees in them. So now that I backed up, this camera's going to be a little focused better. And I'm going to zoom in quite a bit here so you can see these bees are dead. And it's really strange how one died right after the other. They're just lying there dead. So if you think the bees aren't dying all over the world, well, there you go. There's the proof right here. This is a public gardens that doesn't use any chemicals, doesn't use anything. It's originally called the Victoria Public Gardens. And you're watching the bees here. Look at them. They're just about completely dead. They can barely move. And my other video last year that was online, all the commentators in the world that left comments underneath it, no one had a way to explain what was happening to the bees here. So it's kind of neat because I came up and these bees weren't moving and they really looked like they were dead. So I'm going to keep this video going to try to understand what is happening here. It seems to be that they're just barely moving. And I believe there's three of them here. Let's keep watching this. This will just be a second part to my first video that I did last year. I did a couple more last year. If you go to, I believe, where did I? You can go to the visionaryfolkphotographer.com or chemtrailsinourskies.com, and you can find videos about chemtrails, about all the things that are happening to the trees and the plants. So this top one seems to have some life in it. Not much, but it's got some life, but barely. And this one looks like it's stuck underneath the other one. And this one's still not really moving. So something is killing the bees. Something is putting them practically to sleep. I'm gonna back up a little bit here and move a little bit over so we can see this better. And almost ready here. Okay, now I can see the other flower too. And where are they? Right there. Now don't go thinking that it's freezing cold outside, because it's not. But these bees are definitely in trouble. There's something really wrong here. One bee seems to be attacking the other one here, but I'll come right back to this one and I'm going to go over to the other flower right beside here and see. We can probably see on this one. That one hasn't moved. It's just sitting there. And there's other flowers that I can see with my eyes that have bees in them, but I'm trying to turn my camera on to focus in it would be a little difficult. So I'm going to go back to the other flower here and let you watch it. Now you can see the discoloration on all around this white part of the leaf here. The flower, I mean. Look at the edge of the flower. The edges are all brown. Not that side.
Yeah,
let's see. Nope, doesn't look too bad. I can just see the brownness all around the center here. These bees are definitely injured. And what's happening to the bees here is not natural. Look at them. There's one tough bee right here. He's still moving around, but the other two, look at them. So go ahead, scientists. Go ahead, all the deniers in the world. Tell me what the hell's going on here. I showed you the pictures last year, the videos last year. And back to this one. It hasn't moved at all. So I've been recording here for about 8 minutes and you're seeing just what's going on. I mean, the bees moved for a little while, but definitely these bees are sick. There's something really wrong with them. I'm going to zoom out. I'm going to move down a little bit here. Since I'm sitting in my wheelchair, I can roll around on this grass. And I think there's some dead bees in this flower here. Yeah, I think so. It's hard to tell. I'm going to zoom in. And there's the sign of this one. Nope. No dead bee there. It just looked like it from far away, so. Anyway, I'm gonna go back again just to show you a little look around here. Actually, I'm gonna spin around so you can get an idea where I'm at. This is the Halifax Public Gardens, and there's no bees anywhere, okay? If you look all around this gardens, years ago, there'd be bees everywhere. Oh, I found another one. The only time I'm finding any bees around here is the ones that are dead inside the flowers. And so, here we go. I'll show you another one. I'm pretty sure there's a bee in there. What is that? Nope, it's not a bee. This camera sees a lot better than I can. It looked like a bee. So I'm gonna move around a little bit more to see if I can spot another spot where there's some bees in the flowers. But like, as you can see as I'm rolling around here, there's no bees anywhere. I mean, you get all these beautiful flowers. There should be bees everywhere. But there is no bees. Last year, there was a lot of bees, and I mean, there was a lot of bees. But all the plants had dead bees all over them, and I didn't catch on to the idea of doing a video right away, so I didn't show you. But right now, all I'm seeing is any place where there happens to be bees that went into the flowers, they died. And I did find another one here. So here's another one right here for the deniers. There you go, more dead bees. See? And there's another one here. So what I'm showing you is that no matter where I find the bees, I'm only finding dead bees. There's no way that anybody's going to tell me that this is natural. Oh, and I'm going to go down on the leaf here and show you the discoloration on the leaves. They're not natural. So something's happening to the plants and something's happening to the leaves, and the bees are all dying. See all the spots that, you know, like, guys, you know, they did it. They're killing our planet. So I'm going to move back again here and see if I can find some more bees. It's pretty bad. There was a time when you would be looking for live bees. Now I'm just looking for dead ones. I can't find any live ones. You can see I'm rolling all around with a good camera here. You see any bees that are flying around? There's none. It's like I tried to tell you guys last year. You can see with your own eyes that when you see bees, they're usually just dead. But there's no bees anymore. This is the Halifax Public Gardens that I've been coming to for like 20, 30 years. And there used to be all kinds of bees. And I remember that all the plants you see are transplanted here. Most of them are grown in greenhouses and brought in. That's the way the whole commons, I mean, sorry, that's the way the public gardens is done. And these public gardens is actually built on the Halifax Commons, which is being stolen from the people piece by piece by piece. But anyway, I'm getting to be old now. And I've watched the world go from a beautiful, healthy place to a totally insane place full of people that just are really, really, really stupid. They can't understand that this is our planet and we've got to take care of it. So I found another one I'm going to show you here before I turn off my camera. There's two more here. Okay, here we go. The only bees you're finding at the Halifax Public Gardens in Halifax, Nova Scotia, are dead bees. Look. Okay, that's another one. And where is it? Hold on, there's another one here. There we go, another one here. If you go to the visionaryfolkphotographer.com, I will do a page all about the dead bees, and I'll put these. I'm going to do photos today, and I'm going to put the videos on there, so you'll be able to find the other stuff from last year. Thank you for watching. Remember, give a damn about this world. I'm just adding this little clip onto my first part of this video to show you. I went around, and you're going to see on this website or below this video the link to my website where I'm going to put the pictures. And you can see why I'm doing this. I'm showing you that every picture you're going to see that I've taken, the bees are not moving. So there's something really, really, really wrong. The only bees that I can see in this garden are dead ones. I don't see anything flying around. There's hundreds and hundreds of beautiful sprouted, you know, beautiful flowers here, and there's no live bees anywhere. So that's the Halifax Public Gardens. But people, you know, they walk around with this attitude that everything is all right, and all they look for is the easy stuff, the wonderful stuff, things that look really nice. So on the surface, you look around here, and this garden, it looks fantastic. Oh, beautiful flowers everywhere. And you know what? People are gonna start look at the small details of everything in life, because if you don't take care of the little things, the little things become big problems. And right now, we're not taking care of finding out why all our bees are dying everywhere. And there it is. And believe me, I just photographed a bunch of them, and they're all dead. So thank you for watching again, and I'm going to attach this video to the first video that I just did a few minutes ago here at the Halifax Public Gardens. If I see some more interesting stuff to videotape for you, I'll do it for you. Thank you, but it's getting dark out, and it's getting late, so I'm pretty well done. I'm just doing a quick video here. This is at the Halifax Public Gardens, and it's about to close, and I have to leave. But this is a big giant evergreen tree, which is supposed to stay green all year long. But since the lighting is right, and I'm not going to use the zoom here, I'm just going to come really close, and I'm going to show you that if people actually started looking at the plants and trees all around us, okay, everywhere you look at the discoloration. See all the dead plants and the dead leaves? Now look, I'm not zooming in, so I'm coming in really close to show you. Okay, it's everywhere. But people aren't noticing what's happening. They're not looking. Okay, this is a huge tree. And I can go to the top. Now I'm going to use the zoom. Okay, these trees don't turn yellow in fall. Okay, there's no such thing. These are evergreens. Okay, and it's not just this one. It's all of them doing it. Everywhere you look. But the thing is, what I'm telling people to do is start waking up, opening up their eyes. I just did a video a few minutes ago to compile with the one that I did last year of all the bees dying at the Dahlia Garden here at the Public Gardens. And this year I just went over. I couldn't find one live bee. All I could find was dead bees, and there was not very many bees. There's just no bees anywhere. In the world, people know that the bees are dying. So have a good look and open up your eyes when you're walking around. When you see discolored trees and you see leaves falling off of trees all summer long, don't be stupid enough to think that it's fall, because the trees don't lose their leaves until late October. Anyway, this is the very beginning of October right now. And this is a very short video that I'm doing. And I'm going to turn off my camera in a minute. I have to leave because they're locking up all the gates, eh? Okay. Yeah, you have to go out the front one. And so what I'm doing now is I'm just going to give you a little tour of what's left of the public gardens. And it's a very famous place. This used to be called the Victoria Public Gardens, and it's very, very old. On the surface, it looks really nice, but when you zoom into trees, it doesn't matter what trees you zoom into. You go up close, you can see that the trees are not healthy anywhere. These are evergreens again, but a different type. And look at the leaves here. See? So like I said, from a distance, everything looks really good, but when you really take a close look, I'll show you down here. Look at this one. Okay? It's everywhere. Go to chemtrailsinourskies.wordpress.com and start trying to wake the people up and make them realize we've got a really big problem. Because these are not fall colors you're seeing here. This discoloration I'm showing you has been coming on gradually at the beginning of the summer. As soon as the new plants were sprouting, they were having health problems. So again, thank you very much. They're locking all the gates, eh? You have to go out the front. Yeah, all the back gates are all locked now. So here we go. We're having a look at what looks to be a really beautiful garden, but I'm going to do it again. I'm going to show you. People have to look, but people can't see the leaves for the trees. And there's a disease happening, and this is happening all over the world. So I'm going to zoom into this one and take a look at these leaves. See? This is not fall colors. This is stuff that's been happening since last year, since Fukushima. And it was probably happening before that because there's been radiation in the atmosphere, but last year it really got bad. So I can zoom out and it looks really healthy. When you just go by really quick, oh, it looks so pretty. When you look up close, it's the same thing with the evergreens. See, everything's dying. The bees are dying all over the world. The birds are falling out of the sky by the millions. Everything's dying. Why? Because people are too stupid to pay attention to what's happening. So I'll show you again. Okay, I'm just doing this really quick. These aren't fall colors. Everything's still green here. And take a look when I zoom in. Look at the condition of these leaves. You want to call me crazy? Who's the crazy one? At least I can see what's happening. Everybody else is too stupid to notice. They're locking all the gates, eh? You won't be able to get out the other way. So, there you go. You just had a quick look at the Halifax Public Gardens and the pitiful situation. I'm going to go out of the gate here. Leave this camera running for a minute. That's a little tight. Thank you. So as I do this video, you might think that everything looks really healthy. So I'm going to show you some more stuff. I'm going to zoom in again with these 200 times zoom cameras. You can really see the details up close. But you can see them with your bare eyes if you're looking for them when you're walking around. So here we go. We're going to let it focus. You see the disease? It's everywhere. And I'm going to show you something else that's not natural. All the trees are doing this everywhere. And from looking at stuff on YouTube and people looking at my stuff, and I was looking at theirs, I'm going to show you something. On this tree, most of what you see is actually moss. This is what moss looks like. Moss is dark green. It's on the shady side of a tree. But there's a new shit happening on all the trees, all around the whole tree. Some people say it's lichen, and it's not lichen. It's the aluminum material from the chemtrails that's eating the trees. So I'm going to zoom over to a tree over here. And if you look around now, I'm just showing you what to look for, because when you walk around, start looking. See this light yellowish green stuff on here? that's not moss. And this stuff is on all the trees, all around the whole tree. It's on trees that are right out in the sun. And again, the people who are responsible for this definitely won't tell you what they're doing to our environment. But now that I showed you what to look for, when you walk around, look at the trees, look at the tree trunks. It doesn't matter what size a tree is, what age it is. You're gonna see that pale yellowish green stuff on all the trees. And it wasn't like that 3 years ago. So before I turn off my camera, what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna zoom up this street to, there's the Halifax Public Gardens entrance. I'm gonna zoom in to the rest of the trees to show you that all the trees have this stuff on it. So here we go. Remember that a couple years ago, they didn't have this stuff on here.
Is a friend who
by the way, this stuff isn't just on trees. You can find it on buildings, you can find it on siding, you can find it on the tar roofing of houses. This stuff is coming down from the sky, which I call chemtrails, stratospheric geoengineering, is attaching itself to all kinds of different surfaces. I'm having a problem focusing here, just a second. Okay, there we go. So as you see from my video here, it's on all the trees. It's hard to notice for some people the changes, but the grass is not really very green anymore, but grass grows very quickly. So do a lot of other weeds and things. And they could be ill, but you wouldn't know because the next day there's a new sprout of grass growing up. So I'm gonna zoom in across the street to the bush over here to show you what I see with my eyes. The camera can see better than I can. And I'm going to show you how discolored these plants are. You see this? This has been like this all summer. This is not natural. Let's just have a look at the leaves on this tree up close. Now these aren't fall colors. That's not the way fall. When fall happens, the bark, under the bark, the sap stops flowing. When the sap stops flowing, the whole tree changes color at the same time, all the leaves. Fall doesn't do what you're seeing here. This isn't fall that does this. This has been going on all summer. You'll see my videos from last year on my chemtrails in our sky. In our skies.wordpress.com. And now I'm going to add this video for this year's updates. I didn't do as many this year because I've seen enough. I've already proven what's going on. Another thing that I noticed this year is that the leaves are so small, the trees are so unhealthy, that almost every tree in Halifax this summer, when you're standing under a tree, you're still getting hit by the sun. In the past, you could stand under a tree and you'd be completely in the shade and you'd be getting cooled off. And, you know, they talk about global warming. They don't mention the fact that all the trees are dying and the leaves are really thin and skinny this year, and they're not blocking the sun, they're not absorbing the heat, and they're not giving us shade. Global warming is caused by man, but man's the assholes that, you know, corporate criminals that are spraying the planet. And, you know, you got all these mega corporations that are destroying the planet, and they're all insane. So again, like I said, go to chemtrailsinourskies.wordpress.com or chemtrailsinourskies at Facebook. Thank you. Okay, I'm continuing this video. I stopped it, and I'm just going to join these two videos together. I thought it wasn't in super high definition, but it is. My lens is about a foot, less than a foot away from this really powerful light that you can't see. And it'd probably be easier if this was covered over with my finger, so you could see what I mean. This is a side light that lights up the real bright light, but I want you to see this stuff that's flying in the air. It's not rain, and if you see it, it's all different sizes, and it's flying up, it's flying sideways, it's flying in every which direction, and it's not bugs, that shit is chemtrails. That's the nanofibers that are falling out of the stuff they're spraying in our atmosphere. You people should be really concerned that a bunch of lunatics are doing this to our planet. They've been doing this spraying for at least 20 years, but now it's at the point where so many people know about it, they don't even care. Look at this shit coming down from the sky. And if you look around, you'll see in Halifax last year, if you go to chemtrailsinourskies.wordpress.com, you can see all my up-close photos and all my videos I did last year of the condition of all the trees and that light green with stuff that they call lichen, which is not lichen, but it's on the bark of all the trees. Anyway, this year I didn't do too many videos or photos because I was just too depressed looking at all the dead trees everywhere and everything dying. I assure you that with a person who's really paying attention, they can see what's really going on. So now, anybody who wants to doubt that this is happening, you've seen this stuff going in every direction. And I'm going to pan around in a second to show you that it's not raining. I'm going to show you the sidewalk. And I'm going to zoom in if I can here. It's kind of dark out here. Let me move my light over. So, as you can see, it's not raining. It's hard to tell here, but it's not raining. There's no rain coming down. What there is the shit flying in the air. That people are calling nanofibers or chemtrails. See it? So if you wonder why you got a weird cough once in a while and people are all getting sick around you and they're having lung cancer and every other imaginable or unimaginable illness, it's this shit that's flying around in the air. So I'm going to zoom in a little closer to take the other lights up, the other things, objects out. And if you're wondering what kind of camera I'm using, it's a Canon PowerShot SX50. You can get them at Walmart for $350. Just make sure you get a really fast SD card. And it has a little tiny little number inside the C, which looks like a copyright notice, but you want to get a 10. And you can do all this stuff because go out with your camera and start doing videos and showing people what you're finding. Do pictures of all the dead trees and all the mutated plants everywhere. And when I uploaded my videos to YouTube, and all the comments that were coming in, it was confirmed that everything I uncovered here is happening everywhere else in the world. It really is lunatics that are destroying the planet. And remember one thing, people. I'd love to scream this out loud, but it's kind of late at night here and I can't do it. But truthers always sound insane when they're telling you what the insane are doing. I'm a truther. I'm not a conspiracy theorist. I don't theorize on anything. I know the facts. I see what's going on. I read all Agenda 21 from the UN. I read all their documents. Go listen to Alex Jones. That man is pouring out his heart and trying to save our planet. And he's got a lot of followers, but everybody else has to do the same thing. Do what Jesus told you. Don't follow Jesus. See, Jesus set the example. And Jesus had nothing to do with religion. Jesus had to do with your spirit and believing in your in God as your spirit, but there's more than one God. The whole universe is filled with gods. There isn't just one God. There is what there is spirits. And believe me, these little things flying in the air here are not spirits. People are walking by, it's like late at night and at 2:30, 3 o'clock in the morning, and they're all coming out of the bars downtown. They must think I'm crazy sitting out here in a wheelchair in the middle of the night doing these videos. Anyway, go to chemtrailsinourskies.wordpress.com or go to attruthsoldier.wordpress.com and get involved in the worldwide truth revolution. Because truth is the only thing that empowers the individual. Truth, worldwide truth revolution is the only thing that's going to have any possibility of saving our planet from the insane that are destroying it. Corporatism is what the hippies were warning the world about. And corporatism is a much worse, much more insidious, ugly thing than just communism. The problem is everybody's too afraid to pull that corporate image away and look behind it and see what's really going on. It's really scary because we're dealing with some really insane people. And I assure you, there's no hell and there's no devil. All there is heaven and or heaven on earth. But all there is positive spirits or nothing. Because negative has no power. So anybody who's not a truther is a negative influence. And they have no power. They just steal your power from you. Anyway, I'm going to stop with the lecture. And you just watched this video here. You can still see the shit coming down. So I'm turning off my camera. And spread these videos around and tell people what chemtrails looks like. There's what chemtrails looks like. Chemtrails fallout. This is not rain. This is not snow. This is not anything but shit coming down from the clouds. And I was coughing earlier. And I figured, oh, look at that. I can see this shit. You can't see it in this camera, but there's a really bright light here. See it? So that bright light is lighting up the shit that's falling down from the sky. So enjoy. I'm going to try to zoom in, see if I can get an even closer look at this stuff. There you go. The camera might not focus. See how it goes in every direction? That's not rain. Yeah, now you're looking at the material that's flying around that is so tiny that to the naked eye you can't see it. I'm in Halifax right now. It's like 3 o'clock in the morning. At the end of September, around September 26, 2013. The street cleaner is going by, as you can hear. This light that I'm using has got it's a really high powered, like a halogen light, and it's 600 lumens. It's a spotlight, so it lights up really bright in front of me, as you can see over here. And it takes just the right lighting to be able to see the stuff that comes down in the sky. And this is why people have weird coughs all the time. See the stuff? And I'm going to leave the camera going for a little longer so you can see that this stuff flies around in every which direction. It has nothing to do with wind. It's not rain. It's chemtrails fallout. I wish I could get even better focus, but that's not possible. So I'm going to end this video and I'm going to do another part. And I'm going to do it in even higher definition. Okay, what you're looking at now is chemtrails coming down. I've got a really bright light here that you can't see. If I go over there, you can see it's lighting this up. So just keep watching what's flying in front of the lens. My camera is only like about 6 inches from a really powerful light. Right now you're seeing a little white light on the side, but the camera is having a hard time focusing because it's up so close. And I've got it zoomed in even. Now you can see what's going on here. That's a little side marker light. And I want you to see all these specks flying in the air. I started coughing and I was wondering why. And it's not coming off trees. It's not raining. It's not anything. This is at the end of September in Halifax. And this is there's a really high wind and pretty thick clouds up above. I'm just testing this. I've never done this kind of video before, and see if this will work. I'm going to zoom in more. These are not insects either. The camera can't focus this close, so I'm going to back up a little bit. There we go. So I'm going to try another video because this one's not looking that good.